What's a common misconception that the general public has about your job? Accountant, you must be good at math. Requires basic arithmetic. Daycare employees, I wish I could play all day for work, said every annoying parent. Air traffic control, suicide rates aren't really that high in our field. Also, we are not the people with the orange cone lights. A mechanical engineer is not the same as a mechanic. I can't fix a car. Geologist, all I do is look at rocks all day. I haven't looked at a rock for work since I've started down this path. Military, I kill people. Really, I sit at a desk and overspend the taxpayers' money. Water treatment, chlorine is toxic and kills. Get it out of my water. Chlorine saves lives. 3.5 million people die each year because of untreated water. Chemistry, I spend all day making drugs and explosives. Or at least I would make them if somebody asked for it. Unemployed, I only wank twice a day, not four times. Jeez. Get it right. People think it should be really cheap to have their entire house painted by professionals. My recent job, still working through college, is web development. I'm not an IT guy. I don't know how to fix your phone. Just because I work at a gas station does not mean I know why petrol is so expensive. Programmer, everyone thinks I'm a genius hacker when I tirelessly fight with bugs all day. All lawyers are wealthy scumbags. Electrician, it's easy, and any idiot can do it. Therefore, I'm also unintelligent because it's a blue-collar job. Scientist, people think my job is to search for deep truths, understand the meaning of life, and how the world and the universe works. In reality, my main job is to write papers and get grants, so my institution can build its reputation and get money. Most research that is published is wrong in some way, except for analytical work on theory. And not because we are being dishonest. It's because we need to publish a lot and there really isn't time to zero in on an ultimate truth. We just need to get things right enough to publish. And even if we had all the time in the world, there is the issue of experimental design. For one thing, experimental design is very subtle and difficult, and most of the papers I read didn't really do the right experiment to support their point. You can ask them to do more experiments as a reviewer, but as you can expect, this is not your favorite thing to read when your paper is reviewed, because it means more time and money you probably don't have. That brings me to the other problem. Even if you do have the time, do you have the money, enough people, the right equipment, an infinite number of just the right test subjects? You see where this is going. So we write our paper and try to make as big a splash as we can so we can get promoted in our jobs, get tenure, and get more grants. Also because we want to get the information out there for others to use. Research that is unpublished is just a hobby. The institution wants to peddle this work for more clout, so they write up a press release that oversimplified the research and overextrapolates the possible importance of the findings. This is sent to journalists who don't read the actual paper, but rather report based on the press release, an even more overly simplified version of the paper, now with wildly speculative implications for humanity, the earth, and or understanding the universe. This is how you can publish a paper that shows that mice react kind of funny in a statistically significant way to being exposed to a chemical that is commonly used in ink. And then you read in the New York Times about how using ballpoint pens will kill you. Banking, I never see or touch money. My job has nothing to do with money at all. For the last year or so, I haven't been in the games industry anymore. But devs at corporate studios don't get a single goddamn say in what features get coded into games most of the time. They coded in that bullcrap pay-to-win system not because they thought it was a good use of their talents, but because they didn't want to lose their job. They didn't omit that feature you wanted because they thought it sucked, but rather because they already had a laundry list of features to implement, and nowhere near enough time to implement them, and no say in the matter anyway. And that feature shipped super buggy because the project was on far too short of a deadline and CAD didn't get an RC to test until the 11th hour, and stayed up until 5 AM, just to get sanities done at the very least before the game shipped. Yes. They know about that bug. No. There wasn't time to fully test it, fix it, and test it again before shipping. Yes. They put it in the Q4 patch 1.1, When I see gamers screaming on the internet about lazy devs and greedy devs, it makes me want to scream right back, "It's not the devs, you idiots. It's the corporate pinhole copying buzzwords from Kotaku onto his whiteboard, while ignoring the game design document. Indie studios? That's a whole different kettle of fish, though their situation probably isn't what you think it is either. But at big studios, you can safely assume that any argument you are making now, the devs and artists were making to their producer 6 months ago, and the greedy, suit-wearing jackoff at the top of the corporate ladder was ignoring. Also, when a studio posts a fun happy street, Patrick's Day, post on the game's Facebook wall, and you decided to have a huge hissy fit about it screaming get off Facebook and fix your game already, you know that the marketing person isn't a dev, right? You know that those are totally different departments that can work simultaneously, right? Sorry, this stuff just grinds my gears. City planner. No, I cannot get a insert restaurant here. It's a free country. If they want to build here and follow the zoning code, they will build here. I work for the post office. That they might think that I'm lazy or I don't care, this is untrue. I want to provide the best service that I can. But there is a mountain of bureaucracy and manuals between me and making it simple. Stager, and no, we don't care. Talk or hang out with any talent. Person asks, "Who's your favorite artist?" I reply, "Will always be the one who is writing my check." That all songwriters are broke. We are broke and in debt. Pharmacist, I just count pills all day. I counsel your grandma on her blood pressure meds and her diabetes meds, and probably talk to her more than you do. I verify meds so they don't kill you. Paperwork, drugs have many regulations and the paperwork is endless. I deal with your insurance company. I figure out coupon cards that save you money when your insurance company decides to suck peen and charge you $150 for an inhaler. I deal with your doctor not sending in refills, even though we called 7 times already. I make sure the drugs don't kill you. I try to find alternatives for your medications because of the constant drug shortages that have run rampant for 3 years and only got infinitely worse since the hurricane in Puerto Rico where all our manufacturing plants are. Physician, that we charge and bill you for things and then laugh to the bank. Except for small private practices, many of us are employed by large health systems, universities, etc. We bill and code based on strict legal regulations. Then I get a cut from the university / health system. I don't just get to name my price and make you pay. Oh, and me and Big Pharma are not in cahoots. I get $0 from whatever prescriptions you fill. Uber driver. People think this isn't a job, or it's just barely one. You just drive a couple hours and it's like a party, right? Wrong. It's a 10-12 hours a shift up to 6 days a week thing. Heavy overheads, variable income, no job security, and lots of customers are peen bags. You have to constantly worry over ratings, paperwork, maintenance, and so on. You don't get a social life, because the only productive times to be working are when normal people are having their nights out. You have to be able to navigate perfectly in places you've never been to before. But don't get caught looking at your nav, or the customers will lodge an unsafe driving distracted driving complaint. All operating costs are covered by you without reimbursement. Sales. Not all of us are slummy. I'm genuinely trying to help most of the time. I think it depends on the product. I'm business to business, so it's probably not as high pressure as business to consumer. Library assistant / librarian. That it's a quiet, uneventful job. I'm constantly busy, and it is not quiet. Especially during our summer reading program, when hundreds of kids show up. We have to deal with wastes and drug addicts often. And for the love of everything, our patrons have something against our bathrooms, because they are constantly destroyed. Pizza delivery driver, it's late because the driver sucks. It's late because you ordered at 7 p.m. on a Friday night. Software engineer. We are not a bunch of unsociable, inept nerds. Most good devs have really good communication skills and are good at working together, and actually tend to have a variety of skills and interests. The cleaner will clean that up. I'm not scrubbing your hardened crap stains off the toilet bowl rim. Be an adult and clean up after yourself. Sonographers just scan babies all day. Some do. But even then it's not all fun. I do mostly breast ultrasound. Massage therapist. I'm not a masseuse. And I don't give happy endings. Those are prostitutes. I'm a secret shopper and people think it's a scam. It's not. I get to go to fancy restaurants, apartments and hotels. I pay and they pay me back plus whatever rate they have offered, and I agree to. I get to test drive nice cars and learn about latest products. I choose which jobs I take and therefore make my own schedule. I never have to ask my friends to buy crap they don't want. The worst I might have to ask is for them to come out to dinner with me and I'll pay. This only happens when my husband is sick and I promise to get a job that requires two people done. Those are always fun anyway because I never rope him into real work. Only the fun stuff like movies and bowling. It's a lot of work and it's not for everybody but it's not a scam. Engineer. That I know how to fix everything. It is to one extent true, but if I haven't seen it before it is going to take a while. Reddit specific. In a week I'm going to automate your job away. Yeah, that isn't happening anytime soon. Criminal defense paralegal scumbags who exist to get horrible people out of jail. 90 and number 37 of our clients have made a major life mistake and are trying to better themselves. The other 10 and number 37, though. Games master at an escape room. I'm not Jigsaw. I'm a commercial groundskeeper. You'll often see me tending to some shrubs in a parking lot or mowing grass on a boulevard. I'm dressed in rags and I get many looks of pity or even disgust as people think I'm basically a slave or mentally challenged. I have 40 plus sites under contract. I have employees, but still enjoy being out there getting dirty. I dress like that because I can. I clear six figures easy. Owe nothing and my people are paid as much as plumbers and I rarely turn over staff. I've had trashy, greasy haired, scabby, single mothers basically tell their kids that if they didn't stay in school they'd end up like me. Lol. Bitch, you ain't raising kids who are gonna work half as hard as me and the whole bunch of them will be emailing me resumes in a couple years. Social worker. It's not all about child welfare. You can work in almost any field that serves people. Right now I'm a forensic mental health professional. I'm a therapist for serial killers. You can do that with a social work degree. The opportunities are endless. The most versatile professional degree out there. Libraries aren't just for homeless people using the internet. Personal trainer. I don't know what the F dollar sign number they think, but every time I tell someone I'm a personal trainer they say something like that's freaking hot. And then they meet me and realize I'm not a 6'2" bodybuilder slash gym bunny named something like Brock with a chat chin and they immediately assume I must be a bad one. Number 7. Etymology is not the study of bugs. Dental. We couldn't care less if you don't floss. Range safety officer slash gun salesman. I don't just sell to anyone. We turn away people all the time for them saying things that make us uncomfortable or just putting off a lot of bad vibes. Also, half the people I work with despise Trump and the Republican Party to some degree. Graphic design. That doesn't look too hard, I bet. That logo only took 20 minutes. Reality, the amount of time it has taken me to train my eyes to distinguish a difference between pine and evergreen green to be perfect for your logo would make your head spin. Cooking. People make mistakes, including me, the one out of two people in the kitchen cooking for you. Your family of four. And everyone else's family in this place. Give me a second. If you said you wanted it all the way, but you didn't know that meant onions came on it. On a burger, who thought? Because now for some damn reason I have to remake the whole thing. Be patient. Fast food. Yes. It's real work being done by real human beings. Student host. That I literally only sit and play, you know, with teenagers. There's a lot more to it. Non-profit sector employee. The idea that we should take a vow of poverty, that is, work for free or take incredibly low salaries in order to advance the cause or causes we believe in. We have bills to pay and families to support, just like everyone else. And we can't come to our organizations every day to make a difference if we can't make a living ourselves. An organization's executive director is often required by the board of directors to take a salary, even in otherwise volunteer-run organizations. For this very reason. I don't talk specifics about my day job here, because it would make me pretty identifiable. But I can talk about the NSFW stuff. People assume I was forced or manipulated into it. Don't like it. Wouldn't do it if I had another choice. Or that I'm plain dumb. Truth is, it's kinky fun for me. I've given away most of the money I've earned. Money has never been much of a motivator for me, and I make more than I need. I have a well-paying corporate creative gig. The kind with international, all expenses paid travel and a 30k limit on my corporate credit card. And I'm not unintelligent. I'm studying 2 degrees, both in STEM. And my GPA puts me just inside the highest band, in a 7-band scale. I just really really like 6. And I'm a bit of an exhibitionist. This is the best way to fulfill that need without the risk of involving and consenting people, like freaking in public. I work at a marketing and creative agency, which is really hard to explain in itself, so I just default to calling it an ad agency. I work in client services, but I do a variety of mostly digitally oriented branding / campaign projects. Oh, like Mad Men? Not really. I tell them that I started out primarily in social media and then transitioned into digital. Oh, so you sat on Facebook all day, continues to bash social media. Followed by, can you make me a website? Begins tangent on how they aren't an internet expert but they need, like, just a few pages. And like, can't pay me for it. And also want some online ads, too. Software developer equals it. No, I'm not going to fix your computer, or whatever. I don't give two craps about your printer or Wi-Fi acting up. Not a job. But I study in an English major in a non-English speaking country. Most people like to come to me and ask if I could translate their paperwork for free, or you know, throw some random literature vocabularies and ask me for definitions. I work at a homeless shelter. The myth. I work at a wonderful place filled with homeless people who are just so grateful for my help. I work a wonderful and fulfilling job. The truth. I work a job that destroys me emotionally every goddamn day. I work with the homeless, who can be some of the most manipulative people you will ever meet. I've had people get angry and threatening because I wouldn't give them my personal lunch. I've had to encase my heart in a protective layer of jade. 2 weeks ago, I had half the windows on my car smashed in with a crowbar because I wouldn't let someone into an employees only area. This is far from the only time my car has been vandalized at work. Not all homeless people are assholes, but a lot of the long-term homeless are. Size admin, that we can fix anything that uses power. Yes, I can fix a lot of things with an OS, but no, I can't freaking fix your PS4 that you soaked in water. Also, that we seem to know everything about computers. Nope, we just know how to use Google. Court clerk, I'm not being a jerk. I'm just not allowed to tell you anything that could be construed as legal advice. I can tell you how things work procedurally, but not anything specific about how yours may go. We have a huge sign in our office that explains this, yet tons of people still get mad at us. We are not lazy government employees. Our hands are just tied when it comes to a lot of things. Teacher. The holidays are so great, and you have such short hours. Yeah. We get more holidays than some people. We also work major unpaid overtime. I'm paid to be there from 8:30 to 4:30, but if I kept those hours, work would not get corrected. Emails would not be answered. Displays would not be done. Reports would not be written. My typical work day is 7:30 to 5:30. Then you add in weekend work, late nights supervising sports/art events/school tours and school camp. Quite literally a minimum 48-hour period of work, because if a kid wakes up at 4 a.m. guess whose job it is to attend to them? And you quickly realize we earned those holidays. Except we work through those too. Yes. There are some teachers, usually close to retirement, who work the bare minimum. The rest of us just work harder to cover their asses. It is not technically my profession, but fixing computers is my main contribution to my friends and family's needs. I'm not some sort of magical space wizard. I just Google whatever the error code is, then follow instructions until something works. My first accounting professor told me I took a calculus class in college. To this day I still have no idea what that crap was about. He was an accountant for 40 years at that point. CPA. and had done work for the US military, my hero. Working in a factory. No, this isn't 1972 anymore. I do not constantly dodge death and break my back in horrible conditions. I shoot the same 4 bolts for 2 hours at a time, before switching to a different sort of process every 2 hours, and talk with my friends all day. Florist. A lot of people think we play with flowers all day and get to be creative. Often we are working with flowers slash colors selected by customers, making an FTD slash teleflora web design, or accommodating another florist's order sent to us through our network. Our job includes numerous mechanics that nobody sees. Foams, wires, tapes, floral solutions and processing powders, etc. And a ton of people think our job is easy and stress-free. But a lot of people forget that we are the ones making casket sprays for anyone from grandparents to newborn babies. It's hard work. We don't just jam flowers in a vase with a smile. Opera singer, we are not all fat. In fact, only a very small percentage of us are fat. We are singing athletes and more often than not, we are hired based on appearance in this world of HD met broadcasts and hyper-realistic productions. I work in insurance, Australia. People assume that we try to beat down the little guy and not pay out on claims. This isn't true, as I always try every angle to pay out a claim, as that's why you have insurance, to protect you against risk. But the amount of fraudulent claims that cross my desk daily is mind-boggling, especially as we're one of the few companies that still uses hard copy claim forms, so people have actually signed a legally binding document with their dodgy claim. Photographer, I don't just turn my camera on auto, take a few pictures of you then leave taking all your hard-earned money. I operate tight control over my equipment for every photo I take, usually minor adjustments for exposure and aperture, and most of my hours are spent slaving away editing all the photos afterwards. Want to talk about monotonous? Try editing 800 club photos on a Sunday, slash. Former veterinary assistant, future vet tech. It must be fun working with animals and seeing all the puppies and kittens. For every one cute puppy that needs a vaccine is 3 horrifically injured animals in pain that may or may not be euthanized. Programmer, effortless typing out hundreds of lines of code every 20 minutes usually isn't how things go. Most of my time usually consists of problem solving in my head and trying to plan out how to implement something without destroying everything. Factory worker, that automation will take it away any day now. Turns out robots don't give 2 fricks whatsoever about any form of quality assurance. The boxes of stuff you see in the store are the good ones we send to them. You don't see the robot fricking up the bad ones. Because my job is to fix the robot when it does frick up, which is usually often, and make sure the bad ones don't get to you. Video game tester, people think I get paid to play games all day. I play the same game over and over again. Finding bugs. Lately I was correcting spelling issues in French. It's a tedious job and the game stops being fun when you've played it hundreds of times. Librarian. Oh, must be nice to read books all day. While I do read quite a lot, it's never at work. Too busy helping patrons figure out how to use the dang copier. Maybe that only men do my job. I'm a mechanic in the army, but more females are slowly trickling in, and it makes me happy. Architect, I'm still a student. You just draw squares on a piece of paper. What's so stressful about that? Anyone who knows any architects or architecture students will know otherwise. It tech support, I'm a wizard. Printer, oh, so you kill trees for a living. Actually there are forests intentionally planted just for making paper. Want to see forests disappear? Stop using paper. Plumbing. I spend roughly 5% of my time clearing drains. Most of my time is spent repiping gas, water and sewer lines through your building. This is somewhat of a spectrum though. A person working for Otto Router or a similar establishment will spend much more time clearing drains. Most of these guys tend to get labeled as drain cleaners, while someone doing industrial construction will never clear a drain their entire career. Also, don't DIY your plumbing needs outside of switching a trap or a faucet. Just call a licensed professional and live with peace of mind that your house's mechanical system won't kill you. Game developer. People think we are money-grubbing mercenaries who are only in it for the money. While it's true the famous developers you hear about are rich, the rest of us struggles to survive. Most of the shady practices you see going on in the game industry these days is not the developer's fault, but the higher-ups in charge of the project. Making a game is difficult. More difficult than most jobs out there. And most of the time you get almost nothing out of it other than satisfaction of finishing a game. You really need to love this field to insist on it. I can understand people not knowing how glasses work. I didn't before I got into the field. And that there's different kinds. That's fair enough, especially if you never had glasses before. What I'm baffled by is the amount of people who walk into my job, pick a frame from the wall, and put them on, and say why can't I see any better? Optics is just like other medical fields. You need to see a doctor, and have them write a prescription for you. Can't tell you how many I have to see a doctor? I've gotten. What I'm saying, is a common misconception of my job is people think it's like getting your hair cut or nails done. A quick and cheap in and out. No. It's a medical process like getting pills from the pharmacy, or seeing any medical professional. That I do a lot of research in math. I just filter Excel spreadsheets, and make pivot tables that for some reason everyone thinks I'm taking hours to create. Factory work is boring. Factory work is easy. Factory work doesn't pay well. I've been through a few different places now, and can happily say that I will never work outside of a factory again. Even after I have completed my degree. I'm a plant breeder. Oh yes. My neighbor is also breeding some roses every year. That I'm useless and overpaid. I'm a higher education administrator. That apparently is a part of the reason why tuition has skyrocketed in the last couple decades. I'm a little lucky as I'm making 50k as an entry-level professional with a master's degree. But I help to bring in more than $3 million to my university every year. I work in veteran student affairs, and spend most of my time certifying GI Bill. It network admin, that we are overweight nerds, that love CFI. That if a customer annoyed me, I'd frig with their food. Like mate, if I didn't like ya that much of just FKN knock ya block off. Not ruin good I spent hours of my time preparing. Table game dealer people seem to think we want you to lose. We work off tips. We'd prefer if you won, so you can tip us, usually. I'm not commissioned. I'm not trying to convince you not to buy a $30 router, because it makes me look better. No. I don't think that $120 laptop will work for Excel. Karen. Maybe you shouldn't go to a top 50 college with hundreds of thousands in loans, if you can't afford a $600 computer. I'm an archaeology student. Dinosaurs. It's always dinosaurs. We don't do dinosaurs. As an insurance broker, I actually want the best for my clients. We work on their behalf, not the insurance carriers. There seems to be a common perception that we are slimy and constantly looking to screw people.